Shawné Michaelain Holloway here, and I'm a new media artist and poet and just general kind of noise maker. And this is an episode of COSA Connectors. In this series, me and a few friends are showing off our favorite open source tools to make art with and just get generally creative. In addition to being a new media artist, I'm also a professor, so a lot of these tools are the same ones that I'm using in the classroom. Let me show you a few. All right, so today we're gonna be talking about Twine. And Twine, T-W-I-N-E, is a choose your own adventure game engine. This is also sometimes talked about as electronic literature, and electronic literature and games both have been a part of computing history forever. And so I really cherish Twine as a program that can both teach folks about the internet and its relationship to the printed book and the things that words and text really bring to the life of the internet. Twine provides a background of CSS and HTML, and you can really get really fancy with JavaScript and other kinds of coding languages. And the community, which is huge and it's really popular within queer gaming circles, uses this on all levels. You'll see really popular games that are just text and a color, all the way to full-on experiences where things move across the page and music follows you wherever you go. The nice thing about Twine is it's super beginner-friendly. Whether you're an advanced programmer or someone who's never even been on the internet before, there's gonna be something for you in this particular software. The thing about Twine is because we're writing stories, you don't necessarily have to deal with any of the code that other users that might be on the advanced side might wanna get into. So if you're working with a group, it's a really great way to accommodate different skill levels. If you're a beginner, you can really focus on your story and make sure that you have the best narrative possible. And if you're advanced, you can work with JavaScript and CSS to make sure that you have the right environment for that story. Twine is also really great for visual learners and those who are learning narrative structures. Because Twine has both a story mode and a preview mode, we get to understand how our code, the stuff in the editor, then functions visually in our story mode and how it's translated into preview mode. For those of us learning narrative structures, we get to plan out exactly where we want our story to go. The interface is super flexible. You get to move each of these little squares, known as passages, around the screen, positioning them wherever you like. To use Twine, we can access it through an app or through the browser. Twine's information is always saved in the browser cache, which means if you clear the cache or the memory that you store on your computer locally, your story won't be there. Sometimes that's a little unstable, but what it does is it creates a really agile workflow. Through the app, you'll see that you can create libraries full of awesome stories to share. The role Twine can play is to be able to give you agency and control over your story as folks on the other side of the computer screen interact with you, but only on your terms. I said earlier that Twine has a really beautiful, thriving community. Well, I'm thinking maybe this is why. Sometimes the games community relies on agency and choice to be able to share stories that reflect our values and desires. Twine also really brings a lot to the conversation of consent. Twine gives us those important conversations about consent and control that everybody in the technology world should think about. Great. Thanks so much.